How's it going, everybody? I'm Thomas Spohr. I'm from Bennington High School. And this is my poem, Further Into the Fabric. When I Google the greatest entrepreneurs of all time in business class, and I ask, who shaped my world and my shoes? I scan the web for clues to a swoosh that's capturing nation. Only to the realization that my shoes weren't made in the US of A, but a sweatshop in Vietnam, in a town known as Saigon, I begin to hear their song. Because for every millionaire, there's millions more who were never noticed, never saw the fruits from their Nike Hyperdunks, and they sunk further into the fabric. I apprehend and comprehend the voices of Chuck Ty Lamb and Lee Wynn, the nameless ones, who had their 15 minutes of fame stolen. A calm whisper, clear as day, that the Vietnamese who made my shoes paid a dollar a day for manual labor, dangerous conditions we wouldn't think to approach. Then I grasp me and my swoosh. All the Asians that suffered to make the Caucasian that much better, from Rockefeller to the modern day sporting goods, all the millionaires who conceived the concept that they could make a quick buck off of someone else's back, all the squandered human potential and crucial conjuring what could have been for all the Chinese and Malaysians that are slaving over a sneaker that'd be sold on eBay in a year. In that swoosh, the consumers don't consume the faces of those who laid down their lives and graces for their $200 pair of shoes. For every millionaire, thousands more filled with despair, yet with still my Google Phil Knight in business class, I see the GOAT, the GOAT, the grace of all time. I don't comprehend the price of human labor that went into my $200 pair of shoes. From Ray Kroc to Carnegie, the wealthiest empires all built from bags of names never known.